Hello, everybody. Welcome to another exciting episode. As you see, we're getting a fresh coat of paint, making everything look a lot better here for these videos. So anyways, today's first game we're going to be looking at today is Star Wars the Arcade Game on the 32X. Fantastic game. Definitely probably one of the best games on the 32X. This game was developed and published by Sega. It came out November 21st, 1994. In North America, it's an action space simulation game. You can play as either an X-Wing or Y-Wing. Now, I play is similar to the 1983 arcade game, the Star Wars arcade game. So the first level has you intercepting TIE fighters through an asteroid field. Second part of the mission is destroying a Super Star Destroyer. And then third and final is the assault on the Death Star itself. So fantastic game. It does have multiplayer, whereas one player plays as the pilot and the other player plays as gunner. So anyways, let's check it out.
The handheld gamer.
Okay, so here it is. Here is Star Wars the Arcade on the 32X. Now, I saw it way back in the day. My friend Forrest, he got it. And unfortunately, I didn't get to play it. At least I don't remember playing it. He really liked it. As you see, you can tell the graphics are quite improved. I don't think the Genesis would have been able to handle any of this. So the 32X, the module, when you snapped it in, it did improve the graphics. A long time ago in a galaxy far, far away. This is taking place, the New Hope. So, Luke Skywalker. Episode 4. Oh, there it is. I'll let you keep quiet and kind of let it go by. I never did get to play this in the arcade. I saw it, but I didn't get a chance to play in the arcade either. So, I didn't get a chance to play this till much later. But it looked awesome. I did see the machine. It was expensive. I forget how much they were charging, but it was pretty expensive. Whole cockpit and everything. So there's your X-Wing, or you get to play as a Y-Wing also. In the game. There's a 32X mode where they add content, I believe, and stuff. The arcade mode, you can play pilot mode, play as flying the X-Wing, or you can play as a Y-Wing, and you can play multiplayer. One person is the pilot and the other person the gunner. So we're going to light speed. Here we go.
Wipe out enemy fighters.
And now we got some TIE fighters. We gotta take out, get a mission each one. It goes in waves. I think it starts you off 15, 20, 25, and so on. And it's pretty challenging. You have to get used to the controls. Not really hard to get used to. It's just there's a speed up, speed down. Your photon torpedoes, what they call them. I should know it. I watch Star Wars all the time over the years. And your lasers. Besides that, as you can see, the controls are reversed like they always are. They're inverted, where they say so. Up is down, down is up. You're flying through space here. Gotta watch out for the asteroids. The trick I find is to wait till they get on your tail, then slow down all of a sudden, let them pass you, and then just destroy them. Seems to be easier. They're swerving all over the place. There we go. Pick him out. Watch out for the little asteroids there. Now you gotta, if you look at it, the graphics, like I said, they're pretty good. You gotta remember, this is a module that plugs into the Genesis to improve the graphics. So in this aspect, this game I saw, it did its job. I forget what other games that my friend Forrest had. I didn't have a 32X, back then. So I believe he had this, and he had, I think he only had one or two others. He didn't have many. I believe one of the games he had was NBA Jam. And I can't remember the other one. There's one more. It was so long ago, and I never got to play it. He was just kind of hogging it. He must have really enjoyed it. Or I may have, and I've forgotten over the years, but I don't think I played it. I watched, though. Okay, there we go. Got him. Game's a lot of fun. Autopilot R2 takes over. Takes you to the next sector. And then you have to get more TIE fighters. So now I have to get 20. And it's a little tough because you start off with, if you see there's a time, you have a time limit. So you start with 200 and counts down. If you don't get it, you fail the mission, then it's game over. It's also, so not just, yeah, you're fighting against time also to get these TIE fighters. You gotta be fast. You can't just be out there cruising space, wasting time. Ooh, I took some hits there. But as you see, it looks... I really like the graphics. It sounds great. This game definitely was one of the games that was worth owning the 32X for. There weren't many games must-haves, but I would say this is a must-have for the 32X. There's some TIE fighters, and take him out. The TIE bombers, I believe, was where it was. Fighters, TIE bombers. It's cool they destroy in certain ways. You can blow them up, blow off one of their wings, and they'll blow up a certain way, or if you shoot them directly in the middle. Kind of cool how they program the graphics, and especially for back then with limitations and stuff. It's pretty cool what they achieved with this map-on module. It's too bad they moved on too fast. Basically, the 32X was just like a out for a year and really gone. It was swept over really fast. They kind of just moved on to the next, the Sega CD. They were really moving fast. This really was just like a hold me over, kind of an afterthought, I guess. They could have done a little bit more with it, I think. They probably could have extended, so they could have extended it. The life of the 32X a little longer. But they really swept it under the rug and moved on. You shoot a lot of lasers out of there. Gotta watch out for him. I've been blasting. Ooh. Oh, I missed. Oh, okay, yep. Oh, I got him. So now we have to get, was it 25? I can't remember. We got 20 last time, so I think it's 25. Yep, 25. 25 TIE fighters. Oh, they're all bunched up. That's nice. Back then, especially nowadays, when you look at it, it's nothing special. But back then, when it was, you know, the Sega Genesis came out, and you seen these graphics, especially when you've seen these asteroids rotating and seeing the TIE fighters rotating and stuff, it was pretty advanced for its time. At least I thought it was. I was pretty impressed by the graphics back then. I wish I could remember. I think the third game that he had was Doom, if I'm correct. Thinking about it, I was trying to think of that third game that Forrest had, and I'm pretty sure it was Doom. I don't think he had many, because Everybody was moving on really fast. And it was hard to get games for this system. They weren't in abundance everywhere, especially where we were living. So it was tough getting games a little bit too. You'd have to drive over an hour to go down and get games from where we were living. So it wasn't easy for us getting games, and we couldn't go often. We were only teenagers, so we had to rely on his father taking us down there. go to the mall to pick up games. I think later on, when we got older, Forrest, I think, he believed he had a car, so he would drive us down there, and then we would go, that's back in the PlayStation 1 days, so way after this, we'd buy games. Yeah, back then, when this was out, he had to rely on his dad to take us there. Let's see here. Them TIE fighters are pretty tough. They move around pretty fast, so you gotta be quick. And you gotta get used to the controls of down is up, up is down. But you figure it out pretty fast. I really like the game. Time's running low though. I got 23, 22. I'm not gonna pass the mission. When you pass the mission, it's game over. But, as you guys can see, this is what the game's about. Tough game, actually. So, this is Star Wars the Arcade Game on the 32X. So now we'll check out the next one. Okay, so the next game we're going to be checking out is Venture on the Atari 2600. Now, Venture was developed and produced by Exidy. It's an action game, and you play as a character named Winky, and you carry a crossbow, or actually, so I think it's a bow and arrow, and you go into dungeons, watching out for the hall monsters, and then every time you go into a room, you have to either solve the puzzles to get to the treasure without getting killed, and shoot the monsters. The only time you can kill the monsters are when you go into the rooms. Can't kill them outside into the hall areas, but when you go into a room with your bow and arrow, you can kill the monsters, but you also got to watch out, because once you kill them, you can't touch them, because if you touch them, you still die. So even if you shot them and they're laying there, you have to go around them and get to the treasure and get out of the room in time, because if you take too long, there's a monster who's indestructible. And he will start chasing you down, so you have to get in, get out. Then once you clear all the rooms, and you go into the next wave with a bunch of new dungeon rooms, once you collect them, it resets and gets a little harder. So, let's check it out.
And now on to the next video game.
Okay, so here is Venture on the Atari 2600. Now, I played this as a little kid. I was probably about 9 or 10 when I was playing this, sitting in front of the TV. So I believe those are robots, I'm not sure on that. So you play as Winky with your little bow and arrow, going into these rooms, collecting treasure. Like I said, you can't get hit in the hallways. You can only kill monsters inside the treasure rooms. So if you're out, you'll die. Or you'll die like this, getting squished like I just did. Like I said, out here, the ghosts in the hallways, the hall monsters, you cannot get touched by them. You can't kill them. You can only shoot them with your bow and arrow inside the rooms. You have to do it pretty fast, because I'm not sure what time limit you have, but there is an indestructible ghost that comes out after a bit if you take too long. So let me squeeze through there. Winky just barely fit through there. And watch out for the hall monsters. Got to go up around here. Now here's the snakes, gotta kill the snakes and get the treasure. Now you cannot touch their bodies after you kill them or you'll die also, so it makes it tricky, because you make sure you want to kill them and not block your way, get out And there's what I was talking about, the indestructible ghost. He needs to chase you out if you're taking too long. And go in here and kill the skeletons. And get the treasure chest. I believe that's what that is. This game was a lot different than a lot of Atari games, so I really liked it. It was a different experience. And it was one that I played quite a bit over and over the years. So, let's go down. And, oh yeah, we cleared the level. So now here is the second dungeons. Let me get the key, work my way through. I think those are... I don't know what the monsters are. Are all of them the scorpions, maybe? Spiders, scorpions, not sure. I think there are scorpions in there too, but we'll see. There are some griffins, I know that. Let me get up there. Ooh, I thought I was going to die there for a second. Squish through, go down. I'm doing pretty good, actually. I've never been able to flip this level back in the day, so let's see if I can do it. I've never made it past these blue levels. So if I do that, that'll be something new. I've never done. But a fantastic game, as you can see. If you're into Atari 2600 games. Yeah, I grew up with it, so... pretty fun. Even though I grew up with Atari 2600, I really didn't become a gamer until the Nintendo NES. There were certain games on Atari 2600 that captured my eye. But... really didn't become a gamer until the Nintendo came out in NES. But it was a fun game. I played this, Berserk, quite a bit. Spider-Man. I have done something I never done before. I flipped the levels. Pretty cool. So we'll see what happens. I never done it. Okay. It resets, it looks like. Back to the purple robots. It must get a little harder. Seems like they're moving a little faster. So, collect the treasure, get out. Shot him, just get a little extra points. Yeah, the ghost monsters in the hallways are moving a lot faster. So it is tougher. Watch out for the snakes. Oh, that was close. Squeeze through there. Got the treasure. And now I gotta wait for him to get out of the way so I can... get out of here and go to the next room. I'm doing pretty good. At least I'm doing better than I've done. Okay, well, skeleton got me. But, doing pretty good. I still have one life to live. Let's see here. Let me go down. No, I'm not. Well, the ghost monster is protecting that. Okay, let me try it again. Okay, well, I did better than I had done in the past. So, anyways, that is Venture on the Atari 2600. Well, that is it for this episode. We did two fantastic games. We looked at Star Wars on the 32X and Venture on the Atari 2600. Now, with the new layout, I think I got things set up. I'm not sure if the videos are too long, so let me know in the comments if you'd like me just to cover one game, because it seems a little long to me, but you guys can let me know in the comments. If you'd rather see me cover two games per video or just one. And any other things you want me to fix here and there, let me know. Or if you like it the way it is, let me know. Feedback helps and improves the show. So anyways, that is it for this episode. I hope you liked it. Thanks for commenting, liking, subscribing. Thanks for following me wherever you are or whatever platform I'm on. And thanks for everything. Anyways, take care, everybody, and see you next time.
Thank you.